My people, how fun, huh? It's your girl for Lou Storms. When I check in, you know it's BET Breaks Africa time. So let's go. Davido makes history and becomes the first Nigerian musician to win at the SAMAs. So the South African Music Awards are also called the SAMAs to those of you in the know, and it is arguably the most prestigious South African music industry award. Now, for the first time in its 26-year history, it was held virtually due to the pandemic. We know Rona is changing everything, but also for the first time in its history, a Nigerian walked away with one. Kimongoya! We're talking about Nigerian superstar Davido, who won the Rest of Africa Award for his sophomore album, which is called A Good Time. And of course, social media users were abuzz with the good news on the 3rd of August when the winners were announced, and I'm certainly abuzz. So big, big congratulations to David, because not be a small something. And big congratulations to all the winners that night. Hashtag replace Ellen is trending after reports that Ellen could be ending her talk show over the recent investigation. Following her show being investigated for alleged mistreatment, discrimination, and racism, well, Twitter users decided to offer up names of several celebrities that they thought could step into Ellen's shoes. Now, the list was quite interesting because it included names like Tiffany Haddish, Tamira Mowry, of course, Wanda Sykes, and then Jada Pinkett Smith, because why not? But when I saw Dr. Anthony Fauci, I said, come on, guys, let's get serious. What are you doing? Anyways, reports say that Ellen is due to start filming again late this month, but the daytime queen has committed to, as she says, taking steps together to correct the issues. However, no one really knows what that means. I guess it's just provocative. Yvonne Nelson blasts Bollywood and says it is full of hate and jealousy. Ha-ha. So popular Ghanaian actress Yvonne Nelson seems to have some sour grapes because she's squeezing face over what she calls her country's failure to support her work. Well, as all complaints live on Twitter, she took to the social platform again on what days? You guessed it? Monday the 3rd of August. That's Tuesday. To post a series of tweets talking about the issue. Now, the mother of one took to Twitter to note how she says none of her industry colleagues promoted her work on their platforms, and actually they were giving her the whole onlooking treatment even when she would give it to them and say, please help me share, forgetting that a win for one is a win for all. Wahoo! Our weekly shout out, Miss Anne Harriman. Now, we love to see Black excellence front and center, and that is the theme in this year's highly anticipated September edition of British Vogue. A big salute to Mr. Enfield, first of all, the editor-in-chief for this one, because this edition is a very special one, and it is titled Activism Now. It features 20 activists, including people like Jesse Williams, Tamika Mallory, and so many more. And what is important for this shout-out is that it was photographed primarily by Black British Nigerian photographer Miss Anne Harriman. He's also the founder of the What We See movement that you find online. Now, Miss Anne is the first Black male photographer to shoot a British Vogue cover, and we are here for it. Also, Miss Anne's work in photographing and documenting the protests in the UK in the wake of the killing of George Floyd gave much-needed voices and faces to the British leg of the global cry for change. And of course, we salute you, Miss Anne. Congratulations. Don't forget, you want to catch this on with Shasha on BET. Check it out.
Hi, Makadini. I'm Shasha. Catch my exclusive live concert on the 9th of August at 8 p.m. on BET channel 129.
Unfortunately, that's all the time we've got for today's BET Breaks. As always, I've had a blast because the gist is just mwah, sweet. I'll catch you guys again later. Do keep a look right here to BET.